Now we are discussing the interleaving. Interleaving is the part of synchronous TDM, which is the time division multiplexing. So let us focus on the diagram. In the diagram, we can see that there are two circles. Now these two circles are just like the switch. So this one is phi talk about. This is the switch, and this switch is going to move in this particular direction. Now, it is fixed that every time he has to take the transmission from one of the thing. So let us suppose that first of all, on the left hand side, we are having the sender. This one is the sender. And on right hand side, we are having the receiver. Now, sender and receiver, there are three senders actually, which is A, B and C. Now they are going to send their packets. As we already know that in the time division multiplexing, everybody is giving a specific time. Now that time is given with the help of this particular circle. And this circle is acting like a switch, which is taking the data from all of the specific senders. And now these packets are sent to the specific receivers. So first of all, we can say that the synchronous TDM is just like a very fast routing switch. So there are two switches as we have seen in the diagram. One we have already circled. This is the another switch, which is moving into the different direction. So these are the two switches which are moving. Now these switches, they move from device to device at a constant rate on a fixed order. So these switches are moving at the constant rate, means at the constant speed they are moving, and in the fixed order, mean a specific direction they are moving. So we know that there are three senders A, B and C, and they are sending their data. So this way they are going to send the data. As we know that in the time division multiplexing, everybody is given a chance. So first of all, there is a pin. You can see that this pin is like on the A. So here if the pin is on A, now the data of A1 means the first packet of A is taken, and that is allowed to pass from here, and yes, it is added to the frame 1. So this way it is taken. Now after some time, this pin will be going to the next B. So here on the B, B1 is not there. This one is empty. And we already know that if some space is empty, that can also be taken, which is a disadvantage of synchronous. And yes, it is passed through the wire and then it is taken to the frame 1. So this is the empty, which is a wastage of space. Then this switch will be going to the third. Then it will take the next particular packet from the C, because the turn is of C now, and it will be taken and given to the frame 1. So this way the three paths of frame, which is A1 empty and C1 is taken. Now the frame 1 is complete. So this whole frame is sent. So this is the complete frame 1, and it is sent to the next part, which is the receiver. And at the receiver side, we already have the same type of switch. And this switch also moves in the same manner and will take out all the frames out. So first of all, the turn is of A. So we can see that the first A1 will be taken and it is given to the receiver. From here, it is going and given to the receiver. Now afterward, the switch will move. And then the turn of B will come. So this B, this particular frame will be taken, and out of that B will be extracted and it will be taken out, which is space. So space is given to the receiver. Again the switch will move. It will go to the C, line C. It will take the C1 and send to the C1 line. So this will be taken. So this way the whole transmission is going on. And both the switches are synchronized with each other. So if we say that this is the switch 1, S1 and this is a switch 2. These two are synchronized, because if they are not synchronized, there is not possible of the communication. So if one switch is taking the data from A sender, so it should be sent to the A receiver at the same time. So that is how they are synchronized. This is the process where the switches are applied. So synchronous TDM is like a fast routing switch, and switch moves from one device to another at the constant rate in a fixed order, and this process is called interleaving. So interleaving is the process where the switch is moving from one device to another and taking the data. We can compare this switch as the fan regulator. You can see that if we remove the 0 from there, which is off, then 1, 2, 3, if the 3-speed regulator is there, it will go to 1, 2 and 3, and again if we move, it will come back to 1. So similar way, it will take the data from device 1, 2 and 3 and again move back to the 1. So these two regulators or these two routing switch, they are synchronized. One is receiving and another is sending. So multiple frames can be sent in the same manner. So this frame 2 and frame 3 will be sent for correspondingly packets of the sender. So this is called the interleaving under the synchronous TDM. Now we are discussing the framing bits under synchronous TDM. So now we are discussing the framing bits, and framing bits are part of synchronous TDM, means the time division multiplexing. We can see that there are three frames. So one is the frame 1. If we observe the frame 1, we can see that there we are having the three slots. That means there are three particular devices who are sending the data. So this one is the frame 1. Under the frame 1, this is the slot, first slot for, let us suppose that device 1, maybe the D1, or maybe we can say that it is device A. Another is the slot for device 2, and next one is the slot for device 3. So there are three devices. We can say that the name of devices are A, B and C, and these are the first packets, A1 space and C1. So A1 is already there, in the B there is nothing, so it is left blank and C1. Anyhow, but they are combined into the frame 1. Similar way, we are having the frame 2 and frame 3. So these are the frame 1, frame 2 and frame 3. But in frame 1, frame 2 and frame 3, we have seen that there is a number given. The number which are added, just like 0, 1 and 1. So these are what? These are the framing bits. So 101, the number given, these are the framing bits. Means beyond the frame, we are adding something else. So this is one thing we are adding over there, which is extra. So this is extra thing is called the framing bit. So with every frame we are going to add this bit, and because of that we achieve the synchronization. This is called the framing bit. So you can see that there is a synchronization pattern. In this synchronization pattern we are having 101. Similar way, the frame 3, frame 2 and frame 1 are having 101. So that is the synchronization. What is the meaning of that? First of all, we must know one thing, that time slots are fixed for all frame. Means if I talk about frame 1, frame 2 and frame 3, they are having a fixed time slot. Means in that specific time, the frame 1 should reach. If that is not reaching into that specific time, so that will be discarded. So there is a specific time slot, that is the part of TDM, time division multiplexing. We are giving everybody the same time. So same time is given to the frame, and which is further given to the specific devices. Because of that, to remove the time inconsistency, one or more synchronous bits are added to the beginning of each frame. Because the time slot of all the frames are fixed and they should reach a specific time. So we just first of all assign a synchronization pattern, and that pattern we have assigned is 101. So if the 1 is there, then in that case the 1, frame number 1, should be taken. If afterward the 0 is there, then this 0 should be taken and the frame 2 will come afterward. And if again 1 is there, then again this one is for the frame 3. So this way the synchronization pattern is achieved, by which we are adding one bit or the more bits. In this particular diagram we are adding one bit, we can also add multiple bit, that depend upon the situation. So if we are adding that particular bit to the each frame, this is called the framing bit. So the framing bit is added to each of the frame to achieve the synchronization, and that is the part of synchronous TDM.